Hey guys, Fooying Bro here with another Mountain House review. Today is going to be on, since people are liking these reviews, I'm getting some positive response, I'm going to do some more and buy some more as well. Today is on freeze-dried spaghetti with meat sauce. Only 11 grams of protein per serving on this one. Serving size, there's about 2.5 servings per container. Calories, 220 calories from fat, 45. Total calories, 5 grams. Saturated fat, 2 grams. Trans fat, 0 grams. Cholesterol, 20 milligrams. Sodium, and again, 760 milligrams. Tell me, guys, do you think that's a lot of sodium? I find that to be high. I don't know, it's like having a Mountain Dew or something. I don't know, it's a lot. Anyway, potassium, 380 milligrams. Carbohydrates, 31 grams. Dietary fibers, 2 grams. Here we go. Sugars, 2 grams. Protein, 11 grams for your daily percentages. Vitamin A, 20%. Calcium, 4%. Vitamin C, 25%. Iron, 15%. Let's go ahead and look at the ingredients. Enriched spaghetti, a whining dog in the background. And you can go ahead and pause this and take a look at what all the ingredients are. I, for one, don't care for enriched flour goods. And Kitty doesn't like it either. But there we go. Let's go ahead and get this started. We are, of course, going to try this. By the way, it does say contains wheat, soy, and milk. Yeah, Kitty likes milk. Anyway, we are going to go ahead and get this started. We're going to try it just as it is, and we're going to go ahead and add some of the linguiça that was cooked up and that breakfast that I showed earlier, so we can finish that off, but it's just so nummy. And we'll see, go ahead and put this through the test, the Fooying test. Okay, let's get started. Okay, let's go ahead and get started. Go ahead and put the oven on high. This is going to require, and now I'm going to be paying attention here, only 16 ounces. Not 16 ounces, only 16 ounces. So let's go ahead and get that started. Okay, we got 16 ounces there. And I'll be right back once it's done. Okay, this time I'm going to go ahead and see how much water I actually have in there from it boiling. Hopefully the plastic measuring. Well, I just poured a little bit over. It's still 16 ounces, so good. Go ahead and open this sucker up. Take a look inside. So you can see what it looks like. Oh, it looks like there's actually some meat in there. It says meat sauce. I didn't think there was actual meat in there. Yeah, we'll add the linguiça anyway. And let's go ahead and pour this in. It looks like the right amount of water, and we'll go ahead and stir this up. The smell smells like Chef Boyardee's, or no, Campbell's. I'm sorry, it's either Chef Boyardee's or Campbell's. SpaghettiOs. It smells like SpaghettiOs. I'm not a fan of SpaghettiOs. Anyway, we're going to let that sit for 9 minutes. So I might be adding some pepper or something to this because, I'm not a fan of SpaghettiOs. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, so it is done. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. This is one of the times that the water actually seems to be just fine for what it is. Let's go ahead and dump some of this out. It actually seems like quite a bit of food in here. Of course, in the wilderness, we could always scrape that out. Alrighty. What do you think of the smell? Does it smell like anything that smells familiar?
Like, smells like I don't know, fake tomatoes or something.
Fake tomatoes? Oh, does it doesn't smell like something familiar? There's a product that I think it smells like.
It doesn't smell like a really robust.
Yeah. It smells kind of cheapish.
Yeah.
It smells like SpaghettiOs to me. Either Campbell's or whatever the other one is. Anyway, let's go ahead and give it a taste test. It looks really good, actually. And there goes the whining dogs again.
I don't like the sauce. The meat is nice, and like the noodles, they're not like chewy or awful, but I don't like the sauce.
It tastes like the ravioli.
Yeah, it tastes like from a can.
Campbell's ravioli. But it's edible.
Yeah, I mean.
It's tasty. It's not great. It's not like, you know, stuff Mom would make. But it is edible. It's not bad.
Yeah, it's not horrible. I just.
And the texture is fine. The meat actually is not rubbery. It tastes like a fresh meat. And it feels like fresh meat. But you know, we're gonna go ahead this time and add the linguica with onion to this. Oh. You steal my dying heart.
I hope your heart's not dying.
And this will add some flavor to it. Now, of course, when you're out in the wilderness or whatever, a good thing to do to keep you kind of sane is to have a little salt, have a little pepper, something that will give you flavor. Figure out what was in your area of the world that you can get from trees or whatever, mushrooms, that would add some flavor to change up your life a little bit.
They actually have in the section where we bought this a little seasoning thing that you can put with your survival stuff, and it's salt and pepper and paprika and I don't know, four or five things.
Maybe that. Some Mrs. Dash. You know, get yourself a bag of stuff or something. The linguica has a good flavor, but the sauce, it's not a strong flavor, but it's strong enough to overpower the linguica. So when I actually bite into the linguica, I can taste it. But when the first thing I taste is the sauce, which is okay. If you like SpaghettiOs, it's okay. And it's edible, and we will eat it. And then we'll figure out in 4 hours' time if it holds us together with the added meat to it to see if these meals are, you know, you really should have something else with it for the low protein count ones. Anyway, I will be back in 4 hours' time. It hasn't been 4 hours' time, but I just wanted to let you know that it is best used before May 2019. Okay. So it may not be the best tasting thing in the world, but if it gets you through the day, and we'll find out. Okay, it has not been 4 hours, but I must say that the flavor was getting worse as we ate it. My wife actually picked out the lasagna, not the lasagna, the linguica, ate that with the onions, and kind of wiped off the sauce. It was getting kind of gross. So we didn't actually finish the meal. I finished my serving, and she didn't finish hers. So I will give you an honest, I finished it just for the test to see if it will hold me over for at least 4 hours. But the rest of it, I'm probably going to give to the dogs. So, again, another 4 hours, I'll let you know if it actually sustains me. Because that's the purpose of it, is sustaining you. But the flavor, wow, I didn't think SpaghettiOs could get worse, but it was actually getting worse. What was your description? It was like getting
like sauce? Dollar store tomato sauce.
A dollar store tomato sauce. If that gives you any indication on the flavor. Not really good. So why am I filming my cat now? It's because I left my the container out here. And all the other ones, they didn't touch at all. But this one, they decided that they thought this was the cat's meow. I loved it. This is how I found it out there, out here. Just gnawed and chewed up. Anyway, it's been 4 hours. I'm not hungry. I feel just fine. The flavor did last my mouth for a while. The flavor actually got nasty after a while. So I had a glass of milk and it was fine after that. Cat seemed to like it. He really liked it. He loved it, didn't he? Yeah, Mr. Kitty. My wife actually decided to go ahead and eat hers. She said it was a little, like a tiny bit better cold. It wasn't as bad as it was when we first started eating it. But it was still kind of crappy. So all in all, it did what it needed to do by filling me up. I wasn't doing anything strenuous during this time, so I really can't say if the calories would have, sustained me for a while. I did feel a little hungry after about maybe 2 hours, but it wasn't bad. It went away after I had a glass of milk, and that was perfectly fine. So it's just probably because I'm a large man. I don't know. There's so many other ones to go for I'd hate to say to get this one, but like I said, if it did its job by filling me up for that amount of time, then I guess it did its job, but the flavor is just, I don't know, if you like SpaghettiOs and that type of stuff, my wife actually likes SpaghettiOs, she didn't like this, she said it was okay when it was cold, not too horrible, but that might have been the linguica flavor had seeped into the rest of it. Anyway, Mr. Kitty approved. Fu Ying, not so much approved. What do you think, Mr. Kitty? You like it? Yeah, Kitty likes it. Anyway, hope this was informative. You guys all have a good day.